Happy Easter, JHM. My name is Josh. I'm the junior high pastor. And this weekend is a special weekend because we celebrate Jesus rising from the dead. He escaped the tomb and he lives again. He's in heaven preparing a place for us. It is Easter. And so welcome to our service this weekend. Now, I know it's a little different than our normal weekly stream, but it's because we're in a different room and they can't broadcast well from there. So I'm so sad that you had to miss our Easter services, but I'm pumped that you get to at least hear the Easter message here on YouTube. So hello, great to see you. Welcome aboard. I love escape rooms. I don't know if you know, are totally familiar with what an escape room is all about, but it's basically where you and some of your friends get locked into a room, and there's all sorts of clues and mysteries hidden throughout the room that you have to figure out to help you escape. Now, typically you go with some people that you know, your friends, or I've even gone with like some of the youth staff before, and it is such a blast. In fact, here's a picture of us. I think this was right after the escape room. We didn't quite finish it entirely, but we did really good, and it was a blast. It's team building, it's fun. The whole point of it is you're trying to escape. One time I was in a Palm Desert and there was a Titanic themed escape room. And if you didn't make it through the adventure, you went down with the ship. It's so fun. Escape rooms are awesome. If you ever have a chance to go to one with some buddies or friends, you've gotta go. It's also a great date night as well, but that's way in the future. Our love series is over. Okay. Well, here's the deal. One of the greatest movies of all time, a little something called Kung Fu Panda, which we're not sponsored by, but Kung Fu Panda has a great escape scene in it as well. So check out this clip and enjoy.
Now?
Yes.
All right, I don't know if Kung Fu Panda 4 in theaters now, again, not sponsored, is any good, but I sure do love that clip. So good, so awesome. Well, here's the deal. On Easter, we celebrate Jesus rising from the dead. He was crucified on a cross, the Bible says, for our sins, so that we could be forgiven, that his grace and mercy would be poured upon us, so that our brokenness, our shame, our regret, our pain, all the times that we mess up and fall short will be forgiven by Jesus. It's such a beautiful day because he not only was crucified for our sins, but he was buried for 3 days. And on Easter weekend, millions and billions of people across the whole country will celebrate that Jesus came back to life. Now, when he was put into the tomb, and I've actually been there to the exact location that many people believe where Jesus was buried, there was no way anyone was getting out of that tomb. In fact, a gigantic stone was rolled into the tomb's opening, and there's like a little trough there, and when that rock settled into place, there was no moving that thing. In fact, the Bible tells us that they'd actually sealed the tomb as well. And the ruler of that day would have like a ring or a signet, and they would stamp it on the tomb to make sure that everyone knows this thing is sealed and nobody's getting out. But the most amazing thing is, I mean, it's kind of the ultimate escape room, really, because Jesus, after 3 days and three nights on that Sunday morning, rose from the dead. He was in a tomb. That's where dead people go. And he was alive and well. And the stone was rolled away. The seal was broken. The guards were nowhere to be found. And Jesus came back to life. In fact, he would go on to be seen by hundreds and hundreds and maybe even thousands of people until he went to heaven on the day of ascension, where the Bible says he's preparing a place for you and for me. Now, I don't mean to make light of this moment by saying that Jesus conquered the most difficult escape room, but it's a great reminder that there is no escaping death for us. But the one who loves us, the one who gave his life for us, is more powerful than even the one thing that is certain in our life, which is death. He proved his power by raising himself from the dead. In fact, God the Father said, "The spirit that raised Jesus from the dead lives in you." That's a powerful spirit that brought him back to life and gives us life today. As I read this passage in Luke chapter 24, I want you just to think of this moment when people are rushing to the tomb and they found it empty. Here's what the scripture says in Luke 24. It says, "Early on Sunday morning, the women came to the tomb, taking the spices they had prepared. They found that the stone had been rolled away from the entrance. So they went in to the tomb, but they didn't find the body of the Lord Jesus. They stood there puzzled. And two men suddenly appeared to them, clothed in dazzling robes. The women were terrified and bowed their faces to the ground. And the men said, 'Why are you looking for someone among the dead?' 'Because he is alive. He isn't here. He's risen from the dead.'" If you're taking notes this weekend or you've downloaded the program in the description below and you want to write down a few things, here's some stuff that I saw in the passage this week that was so beautiful and life-giving as we celebrate Easter together. Write this down. Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life," and then proved it by conquering sin and death. There's only a few things in life that are certain, and one of them is that there's an ending to it. And I know you're thinking, "I'm in junior high, I'm going to live forever, my parents are the one, or my grandparents are old, but not me, I'm never going to die." Well, at some point, sooner than any of us care to admit, old age comes for you and the grave is coming for all of us. It's the one thing that's certain. And Jesus said, "I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life." And then he proved it by conquering sin and death on the cross and as he rose from the tomb. Second thing I'd want for you to write down is this: know that there is no escaping death, but there is eternal life ahead. As Jesus would go from town to town and village to village saying, "I am the way to eternal or everlasting life." And so while death is a certainty and it's a total downer and bummer and like, this is all going to end one day for me, the beauty of it is that Jesus over and over again and echoed throughout all the pages of Scripture said that there is life after death. Now, to be clear, you don't come back as a potato or a cow or a rock. That isn't how it works. Your soul lives forever. And when we die, the followers of Jesus that believe he is the way, the truth, and the life, that know and are committed to his resurrection, that he is in heaven preparing places, will join him someday. Now, I've been in some tough situations where I wasn't sure that was totally true. I remember when I was about your age, my grandpa died. He'd gotten cancer and his body was withering away. He actually died kind of younger in his old age, and it was so sad and discouraging. But at the funeral service, they said, "You don't need to worry because someday you'll be reunited with him in heaven. And here's the way, through Jesus, the one who conquered sin and death." There is life after death. And it's not reincarnation, or you don't come back as someone else and you didn't have 12 past lives, but there's an opportunity for us to spend an eternity forever in heaven with those that follow Jesus as well. And that is the message of Easter. It was great comfort to me, even in losing someone who I loved so much, because someday I'll get to see them again. Because they love and follow Jesus. They've said, "I believe," and so have I. I want to encourage you with this thought as well. The third fill-in in your notes is this. Remember that God's Spirit, who raised Jesus from the dead, lives in you. So the same Spirit, the Scripture says in the book of Romans chapter 8, it says this. I'll put the verse on the screen too. It says, "The Spirit of God, who raised Jesus from the dead, lives in you. And just as God the Father raised Christ Jesus from the dead, he will give you life in your mortal bodies by the same Spirit living within you." Now, our life and world is broken and messed up, and all too often we see that firsthand. There's a lot of crime and sin and brokenness and war, and the world has been messed up by sin for a long time. And personally, we've messed up. And we've sinned as well. But the best part about it is you don't have to go through life alone, because God's powerful Spirit that resurrected Jesus lives inside of his followers and guides us and helps us and will give us strength. And someday when we die, our mortal bodies, we're not immortal. We don't live forever like they would say of the ancient Greek gods or other. None of us will live forever. But when our mortal bodies pass, God's Spirit will give us eternal life as well. It's a beautiful truth to encourage us today and in the future. Now, as you can tell, as always, I'm wearing a Star Wars t-shirt today because that's what we do in JHM. If you were here this weekend and you wore a Star Wars shirt, I would take a picture with you as well. I brought with me one final illustration for Easter. Here it is. This is the Mandalorian Naboo N1 Starfighter. And some of you are like, "Of course, it's a Star Wars story. Why not?" Well, here's the deal. This is a little symbol of our life. You're cruising through life. You're soaring through life. Everything is good. Everything is awesome. And then because of our sinfulness, our brokenness, we crash and we burn and
our life falls into pieces. Like if I was to really drop this right now, how crazy would that be? And just like it shatters everywhere.
I'm not going to, because this is a precious possession of mine. But if it were to be shattered and destroyed, here's the message of Jesus. That even in our brokenness, our sinfulness, our wickedness, all of the above, and life falls to pieces, the Bible says that because of Jesus and his forgiveness and grace and mercy, he doesn't just put the pieces back together again like a Lego set. He makes us brand new. Here's what it says in 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 17. It says, "This means that anyone who belongs to Christ has become a new person. The old life is gone, a new life has begun." And I want to let you know that if you are a follower of Jesus, if you place your faith and trust in him, you believe that he died on the cross for your sins, was buried, and escape roomed the tomb and is alive in heaven for us, your life is brand new and God's Spirit lives inside of you. I put it this way as one last thought in your notes. Place your faith in Jesus, the one who died in your place. The message of Easter is one of hope and love and forgiveness and eternal life. that can only come through Jesus. Because there is no escaping death, but in a way, there is. Because we could have eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. I hope that encourages you, that makes you excited and happy on this Easter weekend. And I hope that you know that you can hold on to Jesus through all the good, all the bad, and all the ugly that you'll face this year. That is the message of Easter. I have an idea. What if some person, you've made it to the end of the video, congratulations, I'm very proud of you. How about one person who leaves a comment on this video, we'll get you your very own N1 Mandalorian Naboo Starfighter. I bought one for the online stream this week for you. Any comment, we'll pick one at random and we'll make sure you get one when next time you're at JHM. So, I mean, this is pretty sweet. It's pretty awesome. And hopefully it will be a great reminder of when life falls apart, when things go sideways. Hey, that's actually our memory verse for this week as well, that He will be with us and that He is the one who gives us life and eternal life. He makes us brand new. Well, happy Easter. We're so excited. Hopefully you'll be able to join us in person next week in JHM here at Mariners Church in Orange County. We love you. And on behalf of our entire junior high team, let me just say this. Happy Easter. And make sure you leave a comment as well. Let me pray for us and we'll be done. God, thank you for the students that are watching this weekend and hundreds that got to come to church this weekend too. What an exciting time to celebrate new life in you, Jesus, that we can be forgiven and that we can have a hope in heaven. Even after we die, there is an eternal life for those who believe. What a great message. And you showed your power by rising from the dead. We celebrate you today, Jesus. Bless your students this week. Many are on spring break. Help keep them safe, keep them busy and making good choices and all of that. But God, walk with us and give us strength through the days, months, and years ahead. We love you, Jesus. We ask all those things in your name. Amen.